Hello coders, this is Kara and today I'm going to rate programming languages. I will put them on tiers starting from S, which stands for supreme, through A, which is awesome, all the way down to F, which stands for Give this video a thumbs up, aka smash the like button now, because I think you wouldn't want to do it later. Also, if you want to learn more about becoming a software engineer or getting a job at big tech or maybe working at a startup, consider subscribing to this channel and clicking that notification bell so you don't miss any of my new uploads. Let's get rating! So most of the languages I used here are languages that I actually used in real life, and it might be that I wrote thousands of lines of codes in it, or it might be that I just created one program during uni, or in some cases my friends forced me to put them in there and I actually wrote zero lines of code in them, but they are still in this tier list. Small disclaimer, this is a very subjective video and this is just my opinion and my preference, and you can not agree with this and that's fine. And if you don't agree, leave a comment below and tell me why. And if you agree, also leave a comment below to fuel that YouTube algorithm. Let's start with three pairs of twins. Just they are not identical. And also they were born or like a very distant dates from each other. So I'm talking about Kotlin and Java, Swift and Objective-C, and TypeScript and JavaScript. I grouped them all together because there is a common theme here when one of the languages kind of replaced the other one or is in the process of replacing the other one. And as that is happening, there must be a reason behind this replacement and adaptation of the newer language. So we will go through all of that now. Let's start with Kotlin versus Java. They are mostly used for Android and backend applications. As for Kotlin, it straight away lands in S tier for me, as this is my favorite language ever, a really modern language with a beautiful syntax, avoiding all the boilerplate. It's interoperable with all of the other languages, so if you're switching your applications from Java to Kotlin, it's really easy and you can do it gradually. It can also be used as a multi-platform project, so you can write your mobile apps for both iOS and Android, your front-end apps and your back-end apps all in Kotlin, and share a lot of code between them. As for Java, it lands in the C tier for me, because in my opinion, all of the Java applications should be replaced with Kotlin nowadays. But then I also have to acknowledge that actually most of the applications and big servers are now written in Java. It's still one of the most popular languages, with a lot of libraries being implemented exclusively in Java, and it's still a popular choice for new apps. Our second pair of twins, Swift versus Objective-C. They are both used mostly for iOS development. Objective-C is a pain to write in. It looks old, it feels old, it seems like just a little bit better small talk, which is not even a compliment, but because it's so widely used, I will give it a D. As for Swift, people got annoyed with everything that was wrong with Objective-C and came up with replacing it with Swift. It's a modern language with modern features, it's quite performant, it's not such a pain to write in, but it's still very iOS-centric, so it won't get more than B from me. JavaScript and TypeScript. You know them mostly from front-end applications, but you can write servers in them and you can even write native apps in them. JavaScript is actually the first language I learned, which makes me really sad, but at the same time, it's what most of the internet that you can see is built on, so we have to give it some credit. It's not type safe and it feels really messy and I don't like writing in it. TypeScript is a superset of JavaScript and it compiles to pure JavaScript. It gives you type safety and all the other amazing things that come with type safety. It also comes with like classes, interfaces, inheritance, so a lot of things that you would expect to make your app feel more modern. You can use TypeScript instead of JavaScript pretty much anywhere you want now. As a matter of fact, I'm using TypeScript at work full-time right now instead of my beloved Kotlin. So to the rating. JavaScript gets C from me, which is a default tier for it's still widely used, but I don't like it. And TypeScript goes to B because it's actually quite fun to write in, but it's not awesome. Next, we have our nerd twins, R and Python. I call them nerd twins because they are used for advanced maths and statistics. Python is popular, it's easy to learn, it's beginner friendly, it does a lot of the things for you. It comes with a lot of frameworks and libraries. For example, you can pick Django that will allow you to easily create websites with servers and databases. You can pick NumPy that allows you to do crazy math stuff like numerical computing. And that also leads us to support for machine learning and natural language processing. In short, Python lets you do cool things easily. And that's why it gets A from me. As for R, I used it at uni for some statistics and I didn't enjoy that, so we're just gonna give it E. Next up, we have the C family. C, C++, and C sharp, because we already talked about Objective-C. C is great if you want to write performance programs, if you want to learn about memory management, if you want to write programs for embedded systems or microcontrollers. The whole Android operating system is written in C. Pretty much any operating system is written in C. In my opinion, everyone should learn C, because even though modern languages do a lot of the things that you have to manually do in C for you, just knowing what's happening under the hood and how it can be optimized is really important. And that's why C goes to A. So C++ is pretty cool, and most of my bots for my games were written in C++. It's an expanded form of C with object-oriented programming paradigm included, as well as some functional programming there you can find there as well. It's mostly used for writing performant applications like operating systems, browsers, games. So it's A from me. C sharp. If you're into game development, that's probably your language of choice, because it's language of choice for Unity. To me, it looks a little bit like Java wannabe Kotlin, but I didn't really manage. But also I would like to acknowledge that probably Kotlin took a lot of things from C sharp, but just because of the fact that it's so tightly bound to Microsoft system, it gets B from me. So our next pair is assembly and bash. I put them together because it's a pain to write in them, and I don't think anyone should be forced to do that. However, with assembly, learning it gives you a little bit of advantage, as you might better understand how all of the other languages work under the hood, and that can give you a little bit more knowledge about how to optimize things, and that will make you a better programmer. Also, you can write your own compiler if you want. And that's why assembly goes to C. And I don't really want to talk about bash, so let's just put it in E. And now we have our oldies but goldies, Pascal and Smalltalk. Pascal is a little bit like C, but no one uses it. And Smalltalk is a little bit like Objective-C, but no one uses it. Or maybe I should say that Objective-C is more like Smalltalk. Anyway, I was forced to use both of them during uni, and that's why they are going into E. And also because they are useless. Next on, we have PHP. What about Golang? It has really cute logo and it's concurrency focused, so it's enough for me to give it a B, and maybe if I wrote a single line of code in it, it would go even higher up. So last but not least, Haskell and Prolog. These are my two other beloved languages right after Kotlin, but unfortunately they don't have as many applications as Kotlin. Haskell is a purely functional language that forces you to twist your brain and just reiterate over how you think about programming and how you approach solving problems. It's the most type-safe language I have ever used, and I remember we used to say that if it compiles in Haskell, it works. One of my favorite projects I wrote in Haskell was a compiler of a Java-like language that compiled down to LLVM, and that was like the best project during my 5-year uni education. So I would honestly put it in the S tier, but just because it doesn't have as many real-life applications as Kotlin, I can't do that. So I will put it into the S hard tier, which is more like a B, but I love it heaps. Prolog. Prolog is my great love from the times of uni, and again, similar to Haskell, it just twists your brain into approaching the problems differently than you usually think about programming. problems. It's a logical language, and it's mostly used for natural language processing and expert systems. So S-heart again, and cheers to all of you other fellow nerds out there. Let me know in the comments below if you agree with my tiering. What would you change? What would you remove? What would you add? What is your S-tier language? What is your S-heart tier language? What is your tier language? Also, make sure to visit my Discord channel, link in the description below, as well as QR code you can scan here on the screen. We talk there about all of the tech stuff, your projects, my projects, our favorite languages, careers, salaries, anything really. So make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you haven't already, click that subscribe button and this notification bell to not miss any of my other uploads about my favorite languages or my least favorite languages and being a software engineer in general.